centric, like this one, to very hardcore sampling talks. So yeah, come in and say hi. So Arnold is, as you probably all already know, a high-quality production renderer for visual effect and film animation. It is used by many, many studios, hundreds of studios on countless productions. And Arnold was instrumental in the shift towards physically based transparency simulation in production rendering, a role that was recognized by an Academy Award. And Arnold is available as a standalone renderer and inside Maya 3ds Max and other third-party VCCs like Houdini, Cinema 4D, Katana. And here is a few of the productions where Arnold was used recently. A very wide ranging array of animation, VFX, commercials, design. And today I'm going to also announce that we'll be releasing Arnold 5.4 tomorrow. Arnold 5.4 contains tons of new features, like CNC shaders, improvements, and also newly supported features for the GPU beta, which is what I'm going to talk about right now. So Arnold GPU is in public beta. If you're using Arnold right now, if you download Arnold, you have access to the GPU renderer. So Arnold's been a CPU production renderer for 20 years. So why did we went for GPU? The first thing is that workflows are moving towards more and more real-time and interactive loop development lighting. People want to do things in the viewport, they want to do things as fast as possible. Another reason for us to go towards GPU is that everybody has been asking for it for the past 5 years, and we listen to our users. GPUs are getting bigger. If you go for the top of the line with two RTX 8000, you have access to 96 gig of VRAM, and this is starting to be good for production rendering. And another thing is that for small and medium facilities, scaling using GPUs can be easier because like the space it takes, the energy, it can be good. So when we set out to build a GPU renderer, those are the strict set of goals that we put on ourselves. First thing is we wanted to have a single renderer, not Arnold GPU or Arnold CPU. You're using Arnold, and that renderer has to be, the GPU renderer has to be feature compatible, which means that we want to support everything, pixel compatible, we want a good match between GPU and CPU, and API compatible. If you build tools around Arnold, those have to run on the CPU and the GPU. And this is what we mean by a single renderer. The only thing you would have to do if you're an Arnold user, an artist, and you want to use a GPU is take that checkbox. And like if you're going to use the same shaders, the same scene, the same everything, the only thing to do is to have a GPU in your box and take that checkbox. And we want to have that in all the DCCs we support. And this is currently shipping. It's been shipping since March. And whether it's Maya, 3ds Max, Houdini, Cinema 4D, and so on, like all the DCCs. I'm missing Katana on the side, but it's the same Katana, same checkbox. So single renderer, that's the first and main goal and the main philosophy behind the project. So we want a renderer that is feature compatible. We don't want a preview renderer. We want something that you're going to discard. We want to aim for a final frame renderer, and to have a final frame GPU renderer, we want to support all the features. Now, some features are hard to do on the GPU. It's going to take some time. Arnold is super flexible, super customizable, and first we decided to focus on the feature set that enables you to do character loop depth, because incidentally, that's also the kind of asset that is going to fit on your GPU. Is at first. Eventually, we will support everything. The first thing we set out to support is the arbitrary shading networks that you know and love to use in Arnold. Like artists will build those very, very flexible and crazy shading networks. This is shading network that is being used on that robot. And this has been running on the GPU since the first beta we released. We support nearly, like probably 85% of the shaders, all those things are running directly on GPU. And the first thing I want to announce in the Arnold 5.4 that we're going to release tomorrow is we also support OSL. So if you've been writing shaders in OSL, you can now run them on the GPU. A few things are missing, they'll be coming soon. And this is a partnership with the OSL development team and NVIDIA. And yeah, this is shipping soon. So with those sharing networks, support, we can start and move to more complex scenes. And in terms of feature sets for character loop dev, those scenes we condense themselves. So this scene is rendering on an RTX 6000. Of course, this is not real time. This scene is extremely heavy. Oh, you can see that hair is supported. Subsurface scattering is supported. The hard surface integrator is working. Lighting is working. And this is a very good match in CPU GPU. In Arnold 5.4, we're introducing support for the new Renomog SSS, which is an improved subsurface scattering mode that was added in Arnold 5.3. This is now supported on the GPU, as you can see with good speed. We also improved the coverage of our own Uber shader, the standard surface material. Now everything is supported from transmission and scattering, dispersion. We have a very, very good management in CPU and GPU. When we released, we were supporting atmospheric rendering. And the next thing I'm going to announce for Arnold 5.4 on the GPU is we're introducing initial OpenVDB support. This is not going to work as well as on CPU, at least on the first. It's an initial implementation, so it's likely to require more memory. But it is there, and it will be shipping tomorrow. And we're also adding volume displacement. And as you can see, pretty much between CPU and GPU. So one thing that is super important for us is that the scene is being shared by the CPU and the GPU. So anything you put in your scene, whether it's procedural, instances, operators, which we will talk in depth at the talk tomorrow, I think, everything is supported from the start. And if you don't use the GPU, it's fine. I know there's no overhead. But if you do use the GPU, you can switch between devices like. And we will support the scene complexity that Arnold's CPU supports. Instancing works perfectly well. And we even support more pro-oriented features like path expressions for AOV. If you can do helical editing with an GPU, and this has been supported since the first beta. And so this is something new. This is something that we won't ship tomorrow because this requires new and experimental language drivers. But we are going to add on-demand texture loading to Arnold GPU very, very soon, talking weeks. And this is the initial results. Again, first and initial implementation, it will get better. But this already gets us through the door. You can see that on that scene requires 17 gigs of GPU memory. So this doesn't run on a 2080, for example. With on-demand texture loading, the first initial implementation that we have, this runs on 2080. And this is, I'm not going to go over all the features that we added in Arnold 5.4, because we have a limited amount of time, but this is kind of a progress report for the number of features that we're supporting, and things have been increasing quickly. We've been releasing every month, we're releasing betas every 2 weeks, and every day we add new features, new shaders, new lights. And we're going to eventually go to 100% compatibility. The next goal for us, the first one was feature compatibility. The next one is pixel compatibility. So what does it mean? We want a good match between CPU and GPU. And we set out those pixel compatibility goals. The first one is good enough for loop dev, meaning that you're doing loop dev on the GPU, on your machine. And once you like the results, you're confident enough in the renderer so that you can kick that to the render farm and get an image that matches what you were setting on the machine. So that's the first goal, and that's the first goal for the beta, and we're there, as you can see from the previous pictures. Then what we want to have is you kick one shot on the GPU, one shot on the CPU, you can use those in the same production. We want to get there in terms of pixel compatibility level. And eventually, the holy grail is to be to use a device per frame and then use both CPU and GPU on the same frame, and we'll get there. But we really wanted to get something that is already useful to all our users. There'll be some performance trade-offs and things that we need to figure out, but that's the angle. The angle is hybrid memory. And as a kind of a progress update, you can see that match between CPU and GPU is good and is getting better. Our motion blur between CPU and GPU matches perfectly to at the pixel level. Like you could use those two alpha passes as a compositing mask on the CPU and GPU render, and it will work. The sampling patterns, the high quality sampling patterns in Arnold are the same on GPU and CPU. The light samplers, the very high quality light samplers in Arnold, are the same on GPU and CPU. Shading matches very, very well. SSS on character, this is cloth for product design. If you didn't have the CPU and GPU markers at the bottom, you wouldn't know which one is in render mode. Just one was faster, that's it. So those are results made by our users in the forum. Again, good match. And this is the new and improved render mode. I can see all the nice details in the teeth. And this is working perfectly on CPU and GPU. So that's kind of a progress update for where we are in terms of pixel compatibility. Now the next thing is API compatibility, which is harder to explain. But Arnold, what made the success about Arnold is that it's not a black box. Arnold is a rendering library that people also have used to build tools, renderers, plugins, loop dev kits. That's the API we use as well for our integration in Maya, 3ds Max, in all the VCCs. And we really didn't want people to rebuild their tools when we switched to GPU. And we did that. If you build a tool in on top of Arnold, for example, there's a third-party tool that we don't work on, just called Gaffer. Gaffer uses Arnold. Gaffer was able to use Arnold GPU from day one because we were API compatible. So you can build tools around Arnold, but you can also build tools inside Arnold. You can build procedurals, you can build shaders, you can build cameras. And if you're writing those tools, you should be able to use the same exact API whether it's rendering on GPU and CPU. And that's something we've been working on, and it's something we use internally. We haven't released that because we really want to make sure that it's good before we release it, because we don't want you guys to work for nothing. But we do use it internally, and it will get there eventually. So Arnold GPU is in public beta, and we do improve it at every release, and if you want to get into the private beta program, we will release a private beta every 2 weeks. And please, if you use it, give us feedback, send us images. We're super happy to help debug and just to know it works. On the GPU runs only on